Here's how you can install and download Bloxstrap on Roblox in 2024. So you're going to go to my website, linked in the description below, and on that website, there will be a link to this GitHub page. And this is the only official place that you can download this from. Again, it states it right here. The only official place to download Bloxstrap are on this GitHub repository and BloxstrapLabs.com. So be very careful and make sure you're only using these two sources to actually go ahead and download this. But you're going to go ahead to the releases, and you're going to click on Bloxstrap V2.7 or whatever the newest release is, and then you're going to scroll down to the bottom. And you're going to want to download this exe file right here. It's going to go ahead and download, and then you're going to go ahead and open it up. You can also find it in your files, but this is what it's going to pop up, and you're just going to want to click in English or whatever language you're in. And now we have a ton of different options that come up before we're going to even install Bloxstrap. This is going to let you customize the settings so it can install them, but you can always go back and change them, and I'll show you that. And I'll show you how to do that in a second. So there's different mods. So I'm going to use the old death sound, and I'm going to make the cursor the 2013 one, and I'm going to make Bloxstrap's icon the 2008 Roblox icon. Then I'm going to go ahead and click install. Now you can do as much as you want with fast flags and other settings. In fact, I do have a fast flags video if you guys are interested in that. I'll link it in the description below and it should be on my website. But we're going to go ahead and install this. And as you can see, we also do have the old Roblox logo, which is pretty cool. All right. And as you can see, my cursor is the exact one that I said a second ago. And now to open up Bloxstrap, change settings, you can obviously just type in Bloxstrap and then open this menu up. You can also enable activity tracking, which tracks what specific game you're playing on. And I'm pretty sure that also puts it onto your Discord status. And there's a lot more different settings on here that you guys can go customize. Make sure to smash a fat like on this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.